One Piece, the legend begins. 120 years had passed after the assassination of the legendary king of the D clan. The plans of slavery for the much weaker and lesser intelligent species and races was put into full effect by Imu, who feared the ideologies of the ancient kingdom, who wanted to promote equality and uniting all races and species by destroying the red line that sat at the epicentrum of the world of One Piece, thus teaming up with 20 other kings who ruled 20 different kingdoms and whipping the ancient kingdom and the existence of the history during the void century. Welcome everyone for today's video about One Piece. Before anything else, please do like, comment and subscribe on this channel. Click on the bell sign to get notification on my latest uploads videos. Sit back and enjoy. However, 800 years later after the void century, the 20 kings who later on became the celestial dragons were responsible for the destruction of the ancient kingdom, which resulted in the emergence of the world government and navy which came up, and as a result of slavery and oppression of different species that took center stage as initiated by the 20 kingdoms that overthrew the ancient civilization that had all races together under one sovereign king who wore the straw hat of legends that Imu seized. A hat with a piece of power from that giant hat would end up in Roger's hands 800 plus year later, who then passed it on to Shanks and who later on passed it on to Luffy. The Kojiki clan belonging to the ancient kingdom was forced to the then present kingdom of Wano as stonesmiths that not only carved bone glyphs but legendary swords as well. Zunisha, being part of one of the supporting ancient weapons, was tasked to carry the minks that served the Kojiki clan and protected the road bone glyph that leads to Laugh Tale. That was when Zunisha was only 100 years old. The Mermaid Prince had already communicated with Joy Boy about the plan to unite everything in One Piece. However, before they could finalize their plan to destroy the Red Line and unit all seas, North, East, West, and South Blue, however, the plan failed after he was captured. The Kojiki Stonesmiths were tasked four things by Joy Boy before he died. 1. To create bone glyphs and using the ancient language understood only by the races that belonged to the ancient kingdom. 2. Create four red bone glyph that directs the final island with the real true history of One Piece, information about the three ancient weapons and their current location. 3. Information on how to have full mastery of Haki. Information of the list of support ancient weapons and the power that was bestowed to tribes that saved the legendary king. Kojiki clan leader with the power of hear and control land King Zunisha, Mermaid Princess with the power to control and communicate with the Sea Kings. However, above them all is a chosen member who carries the will of the D family, who has acquired full mastery of hearing the voice of Thing, will have the power to control all sea, air, and land kings, of power similar to the legendary king from the D family who ruled the ancient kingdom. 4. To make a pawn glyph with an apology letter from Joy Boy, who failed to fulfill his promise when he was captured by the enemy. 800 years later, Roger embarked on a journey with his crew. Like Luffy, Roger did free certain islands that were under the oppression of the world government. He reached to the final island but did not understand the true meaning of the pawn glyphs. So he acquired a new power, which is the ability to hear the voice of everything. It was at this point when Roger decided to learn the true history. He read all the pawn glyphs with help of Kojiki Daimyo, and three things were apparent. 1. He realized who the real enemies was. He was not in good shape to fight the real enemy, and all the ancient weapons were required for everything to be necessary, of which Shirahoshi was born few years later after his death. He told his whole crew together with Koshiki Odin the true history of the world of One Piece and Whitebeard before he passed away. His speech as he was walking to the execution platform in Loketown. Inherited will. Destiny of the age. The dreams of the people. These are things that will not be stopped. As long as people continue to pursue the meaning of freedom. These things will never cease to be. He left a huge hint as to what One Piece really is, the true history behind it, what the world government did, that will destroy the whole world once the full will of D is fully awakened, otherwise Rayleigh wouldn't be stealing money in auctions if it was some treasures. Rayleigh knew as soon as he met Luffy after hearing what Shanks told him. About a boy who said the same thing as Roger did. Rayleigh then remembered his captain's last words, "I'm not going to die, partner." Rayleigh, in order to see if there was some resemblance of Luffy to Roger. He then stated, "The enemies will be strong, can you conquer such a terrifying sea?" to Luffy. But he replied, "I don't want to conquer anything, it's just that the person who has the most freedom of sailing is the Pirate King." The same words Roger said to Shiki when he tried to pressure him to join him after he had found Uranus, one of the ancient weapon. Like Luffy, Roger wanted the freedom to do as he pleases. He went from being a pirate to being a revolutionary, which probably piqued Monkey D. Dragon's interest as he realized how corrupt the world government was and hated the nobles and celestial dragons. Another hint, Whitebeard's speech. The man Roger is waiting for, at the very least, is definitely not you teach. Just like those who carry on Roger's will, I am sure there will be someone who eventually fulfill Ace's will. Sengoku, you and the world government all fear that battle engulfing the whole world that will eventually come. As soon as someone finds that treasure, the world will be turned upside down. And someone will find it. One Piece. Exist. Everything all goes back to freedom from oppressors who pose to be heroes of justice and controls things from behind, doing the most inhumane thing. Aokiji, having realized the ins and outs of the Sekai Sifu world government, he started questioning things and seeing things more clearly. He realized what his friend Jaguar D. Saul, whom he killed, was trying to tell him something about the bone glyphs. Aokiji got really interested and started exploring and realized if he is to reach to Raftel, the only crew to join is the Blackbeard Pirates. Like Aokiji, Fujitora has the same perception and can't really tell what to think of Luffy. The mysterious Straw Hat Admiral Joa and the existence of the Uranus has something to do with the passing on of the will. D. Zoro noticed something rather unusual with the crew. Each time they go from island to island, the whole crew powers up. Aokiji, when he first met the crew, he mentioned the same thing. "I have fought and came across different pirates' crews that were tough, but your crew scares the living soul out of me," since he knew how disturbingly strong the crew was getting. And again, when Luffy used the King's Haki during the war at Marineford. Luffy's first year as a pirate, he beat Alvida, Buggy, Captain Kuro, Don Krieg, Arlong, Crocodile, two members CP9 Bluno and Rob Lucci, and then Moria. Shanks, before handing that Straw Hat, he noticed something unusual too. "I have had so many great adventures with that Straw Hat, bring it back once you have become a great pirate." Doflamingo's speech to Magellan. "Don't tell me you are protecting me, Magellan," as he arrived the assassin. "To make sure I don't spill the beans about the national treasure of Marius Joa to anyone. Honestly, it shouldn't matter if people find out. Power has a short shelf life, it rots faster than you would believe." Then a giant Straw Hat is seen at Pangaea. Imu holding two bounty posters of two people from the D family. Realizing that the power of the straw hat was being transferred to either one of them as the giant straw hat power was starting to slowly decrease in power and his has to eliminate the enemy as quickly as possible, something he became more aware of during Roger's time when the power was starting to weaken as well. Kaido, Big Mom, and Lock's crew were not mentioned just for the fun of it. The final crew will comprise of the defeated Yonko's captains and the strongest new pirate captain of Lock's going against the Straw Hats because Shanks would have been killed by them. Blackbeard will have obtained three broken devil fruits. Luffy will be the only other person apart from the legendary Ancient King to have an awakened King's Haki that allowed him to negate Devil Fruit abilities, thus making all of Blackbeard's Devil Fruit of no effect to him only as a result of having attended immortality. Just like the Gorosei, who haven't aged at all since the Opoku no Mi surgery was performed on them just after the Void Century. When Robin was 8 years old and current, they all still looked the same. Nor wonder Sengoku and the world government wanted to buy the devil fruit for 5 billion belly. Which means Luffy has to defeat Kaido, Big Mom, Lock's pirates, then Blackbeard at Raftel, since Robin will be kidnapped by Blackbeard, who will use her Beaver card to follow the Straw Hat's crew, then Imu, the Gorosei, and the Navy after finding One Piece. In order to pass and sail through, Luffy has to beat the Navy, Gorosei, and Imu before becoming the real Pirate King. A battle for ages, all the saved islands, the Kuja pirates, the Straw Hat Grand Fleet, legendary Wano Samurai, Dressrosa Army, Neptune Army, Arabasta Army, everyone will gather as the greatest war ever to happen will take center stage. As Pirate King Crown, Luffy takes center stage with his four Yonko level commanders, Zoro, Sanji, Marco and Jim, arriving and making an entry that will shock the whole One Piece world. Broadcasted live with a King's Haki strong enough to make Vice Admiral, Marine Elites kneel and the Fleet Admiral Sakazuki sweating in fear, causing an earthquake. Even Garp would be petrified by the level of power his grandson would have attained that is above his and Roger's by far when they were in their prime. Eclipsing even the legendary king of the Ancient Kingdom who owned the Straw Hat that was stolen by Imu 20YRS after the assassination of the legendary king, the death of Joy Boy and 15 years before the Void Century. What will happen once the full power of the giant Straw Hat has been fully transferred to Luffy? What kind of king will Luffy become? The whole world is now watching and Luffy enters Marine walking straight down into the Marine Ford Plaza. He begins his speech. Luffy. I've been to Raftel, with my crew for the last 2 years. One of my crew member Robin before she died, she fulfilled her dream of reading the true history and shared it with the entire crew. However, there was one more Poneglyph that emergence once I acquired full mastery of the hearing the voice of all. However, there was one more Poneglyph that emergence once I acquired full mastery of the hearing the voice of all things. There's a mystery person that neither the Navy or the world knows, but only the Gorosei knows, that sits on the so-called empty throne. He's the real enemy. Even the allied nations of the world government were lied to. King Nefertari, one of the 20 kings, do any one of you know why he never joined the other kings who became celestial dragons at Marius Joa? It's because he realized he was deceived and regretted siding with the guy who controls everything. Marine Elite, runs to Akainu. Gensei, we have received orders to kill Mugiwara immediately. Gorosei with Imu, watching the live broadcast. This is what I had feared all along, it started with Roger, now this kid. Luffy continues his speech. All the people you Marines killed, in the name of justice were villains, Shirahij, Ace, they all died in vain. Gigi, you being used all your life. Now let me tell you the real enemy and his name, who happens to be the one who rules this world. Luffy, using his future observational, he foresaw Akainu's action and told him not to move an inch, it's useless. Admiral tried to ambush Luffy but Sanji stopped him immediately. Luffy told them directly, it's pointless attacking us now because half of my crew members, they are all Yonko level. It's best you don't do anything. He asked his grandfather, if he knows who Imu was. The whole world is shocked. Franky, having modified Thousand Sunny to Pluton, proceeds with the ship further into the docking plaza. Then Luffy asks the WG, do you know what that is? That's my ship Pluton. Then Shirahoshi swims near the shore where Pluton is and Luffy asks, don't you know her? The Marines mumbling and talking, isn't that the mermaid princess, but why is she there? Luffy replies, that's Poseidon. Then the ancient dragon, the king of the skies, flies towards the plaza. Do you know who that is? Everyone shocked to see Monkey D. Dragon, that's Uranus. Imu, Garosii, and Navy, get ready now. I am going to crush and destroy you once and for all. Let's find out. Thank you for watching Capitan Seote YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe.